Probably the most noteworthy thing about Percival Lowell's career as an astronomer isn't what he got right, but what he got wrong. Despite this, his name lives on, and his contributions to astronomy can't be overlooked. In 1876, he graduated with distinction from Harvard University with a degree in mathematics. After running a cotton mill for 6 years following his graduation, he traveled to the Far East, even serving as a foreign secretary and counselor for a Korean diplomatic mission. He wrote extensively about the culture, landscape, and people of Korea and Japan. Upon returning to the United States in 1893, he became fascinated by the planet Mars after reading a book by the French astronomer Camille Flammarion. Of particular interest were markings that had been illustrated by Italian astronomer Giovanni Schiaparelli. Schiaparelli had described these markings as canali, an Italian word that means grooves or channels. Lowell wasn't fluent in Italian, so he read this word to mean canals. Canals implied intelligent life. Lowell wrote numerous texts about civilizations that could use these waterways to irrigate their arid planet. He spent 15 years charting and mapping these markings as he saw them through the eyepiece at the observatory he built near Flagstaff in what would become the state of Arizona. The location was ideal for astronomical observation because it had few clouds, was at a high elevation, and far from city lights. Prior to that, observatories were usually built adjacent to the universities that sponsored them, and that meant they were located in larger cities. For more than 80 years, Lowell's view of a Mars riddled with canals captured the public imagination and served as inspiration for numerous science fiction novels, including H.G. Wells' classic, The War of the Worlds. In 1965, that view of Mars was abandoned when the Mariner 4 spacecraft flew by the red planet and showed that Lowell's canals were merely someone seeing what he wanted to see, rather than what was there. Lowell also thought that there was a planet beyond Uranus and Neptune that was causing perturbations in their orbits. Starting in 1906, he set about looking for this elusive Planet X. Lowell died before the search was completed, but in 1930, a young astronomer named Clyde Tombaugh found an object where Lowell had predicted it would be. Lowell's calculations were off because the calculated mass of Neptune was inaccurate. Tombaugh's discovery of Pluto was almost as much luck as planning. Despite his errors, Lowell left a legacy of the discovery of a new world and his building of observatories where they could get the best views. His writings were immensely popular and captured the public's imagination in a way we wouldn't see again until Carl Sagan. He brought astronomy to the common people, and that's why Percival Lowell is the Planet of Mystery, Cool Astronomy Person of the Week.